What's up, y'all? What's up, everybody on YouTube? What's up, everybody else about to join the stream? This is the day 278 Make It Songbringer, and today I'm working on the fountain entrance. This thing is where you you drink using a cup. It has arrived! What has arrived? What'd you get? Huh? So this is kind of what it is, where you drink from this fountain. Oops. Z was off there. And you fall over, you fall into this trance, and you wake up in a different dungeon. So, just working on the entities and stuff like that for right now. So starting on, you know, getting this collision detection working, getting the reflections working and all that. Your Steam controller, how do you like it? How is it, man? Yo, what's up? So wait, how do I say co-materion? How do I say your...
There's some up in the thing.
You already listened in there?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry.
Boogie, what's up? Hey, guys. Oh, you gotta wait a week? Oh. Dang. It's a long time. Whole week. Alright, so before I fix up all these entities and stuff, sounds right? Co-Materion? Alright. What's up, man? Welcome to the live stream! So, I think what I'm gonna do first is make this area look a little bit better, right? I wanna add some more curvy-looking tree patterns to the sides, and then I wanna add something like maybe a circle, almost like a lake around this thing, but then there's a little, like, island isthmus type thing in the middle. So that's what I'm working on. And then eventually, you know, my goal for today is basically to hook it all up so you can use your cup. Well, that was crazy. And, you know, drink from the fountain and wake up in the other dungeon. So, oh man, I gotta show you guys this. This is really cool. I added the ability for entity nodes to have children now. So children, this is so great for making complex entities like this, like an entrance. The entrance has several different components, right? In just for itself. And then it has lots of different children components. So I actually got rid of about 100 lines of code this morning by being able to do children components. And this is really gonna be powerful for the future. I can have infinite amounts of children components inside a single entity. So it's gonna make it awesome. Yeah, cool. You got a Steam controller too? Right on. How do you like the haptic feedback? And also the other stuff. Those touchpad things. How do they function? How do you like that? What's up, Arcane? Welcome. Welcome, welcome, welcome. Excuse me. Okay. So let's do this pattern. Area patterns. I think I got a special pattern. Yeah, here's pattern entrance two. This is, I don't know if this is the right thing. Why did I do this? Gesundheit, thank you. Pattern entrance two. Yeah, so right now it's subdividing these patterns into different pattern functions. I think this would be better if it did this inside the pattern entrance function. So I'm going to leave that as pattern entrance, and then inside pattern entrance, we'll do some conditional stuff and where did this pattern entrance go? Oh, there it is. Yeah, so if it's pattern entrance two, does a different function. Okay, so it takes a, you're saying it takes a little getting used to? I hear you. Maybe I'll do this a different way. I got a new system where you can do patterns a little bit better. But for What's up, State Off? I saying that right? Is it State Off or State Of? I'm saying State Off because it's you got two F's there, but I might be wrong. Yeah, so here's all those statues and stuff. Oh, statues would be a cool thing to add to here too. All right, instead of adding a whole new function, because I think this code is going to belong somewhere else at some point. So I'm going to go, if this is the third level entrance, we're just going to do some custom code here. I'm not even going to add a new function yet. So this should now have basically nothing. State off. Gotcha. Right on. So, yeah, now we got nothing on this screen at all. Next, even walk off. No, you can't walk off there because there's no exit component. Okay, so the next thing, I like the way pattern two is looking. In fact, this pattern two entrance thing needs to be right by a pattern, this other pattern. So yeah, this code needs to be refactored into a better place. But for now, I'm just leaving it all right here. Lighter Thief, what's up, buddy? How you doing, man? How's that new art you're working on going? Oh yeah, here's how it does a circle pattern around the sides. In fact, let's keep it like this, kind of. Alex Pita, Scottish Pizza. What's up, you guys? Nice. Yeah, I'm great, man. Yeah, things are going really amazing. Yeah, just lots of lots of really helpful stuff added to the game this week, especially making it really clear what input device you're using and what buttons to press to get to use certain items. So basically stuff that makes it better for new players. Makes it so the game's a little more self-explanatory. See any statue tiles here? What is that equipped to G? Let's see, what was that? Oh, that's the right for now. That's the charge attack. I just use the same icon as the blink orb. But yeah, that's. Oh, you gotta take the sword out for that. That's this thing. I haven't finished it yet. This is not done artwork, but yeah, it needs a better icon, and it needs a better. I want to do a better animation for that too. Yeah, so that's one of the items you'll find, or abilities you'll find inside this one of these dungeons, the psychedelic dungeons. These are where you gain your abilities and stuff, your chi abilities. So I'm not seeing any rocks. That's because I don't think we have a statue tile defined for. Here's some statues. Seer stone. We want to go all the way down to psychedelic. And here, let's add a statue. So what's great about this is I can add different artwork for, you know, other kinds of statues, but for now, that's kind of cool. Oh, we gotta add, first of all, the entrance tile. And I think this thing should be H2 minus 1. Yeah, I can't wait to organize all these patterns. These are not that great yet. Cool. All right, we got the pattern for... I mean, we got the... this thing set up. Gosh, gotta fix that Z. This is a weird one because right here, you want the Z of this to be above the player. But right here, you want it to be kind of on the ground, so the player is always above it. I don't know. Yeah, that's kind of like a circle. I'm going to make this circle a little thicker, though. Yeah, let's... first of all, let's comment out these Stonehenge rocks for a second. And then I want to make this the water... I want it to be, the water to be a little thicker, so two thick, or maybe three. Yo, what's up, Jules? How you doing, man? Welcome to the stream today. X is not equal to W2... okay. This is just a... There's got to be a better way to draw a circle than this. Yeah, I got a better way to draw a circle. So I'll do. I got this new method called this for each tile. It's really awesome. You can pass in whatever you want. I'm gonna capture this, and then you take an int x, int y. So for each tile, we want to do the center of let's be a center position. Yeah. This fountain is an entrance to the psychedelic dungeon. So you drink from the fountain, you get totally tripped out. You fall asleep. You wake up and you're inside this psychedelic trippy dungeon. Jib's gone too. In this dungeon, you wake up, Jib's not there, and your sword is gone as well. So you're like helpless and like starts off kind of like crazy. You stream for the first time, man. Crazy. So, oh no, I hope you didn't get trolled bad. Was it a bad troll? Oh, I hate bad trolls. I'm really lucky. I haven't had any bad trolls in a while. You kind of get your troll defenses up, you know? Eventually you get to the point where you're like, trolls don't troll you as much, I guess. You just don't. What kind of troll situation was it? It was bad? Damn. Who won the Indy Cup? Anti-Hero. Yeah, check out this guy's game. I think it's called... yeah. It's called Anti-Hero, but I forget what his website was. Anti-Hero game. Here it is. Yeah, so here's his game. Anti-Hero game. It's like you're running a thieves guild and stuff. It's a cool guy too. Yeah, but Songbringer got the audience choice. That was pretty cool. Right, yeah, so won the audience choice. Basically, there were 7 finalists already chosen based on their trailers and things like that. So the judges had never even played the games before they chose the 7 finalists. The day of the event at Indie Cup, they chose one more finalist, which was the audience choice, and Songbringer won that. So I was able to present the game in front of everybody at Indie Cup, and yeah, almost won the $10,000 prize. Pretty happy. It was a great day. Got especially watching people play was one of the most valuable things. Watching people play right in person, and yeah, and so all this week I've been working on things where the game should have been more self-explanatory. Like, is there footage of the presentation there? My friend did film it on his phone, but he never sent it to me. Maybe I'll try and bug him about it and see if I can get some footage. So we'll do a center point of the water at W2H2-1. And this is also where we want to put the tile for the entrance. And here we're just going to get the distance. From this point to the center point. Yeah. Yeah, it's cool. I'll see if I can get it. Oh, we got to capture center. All right, so if the distance is like greater than or equal to 3 or so, and the distance is less than or equal to 5, then we're gonna draw some water. So this is a much simpler way to draw a circle and keep some thickness in the circle. So we don't need this one anymore. The only thing we do want to make sure is that the player can walk in at some point. So if X is like less than, well, we'll keep it all like that for now. Thanks, it was, yeah. What's up, Rega? Yo, what's up? Thanks for your comments on the video, man. Nice, cool. You're working on online multiplayer for it? Whoa. Okay, so that's looking a little weird. I want the top, I want it to be a little rounder in the middle. Oh, and also it's a little bit misaligned because all these fountain entrance things. Entrance, yeah, we want to do just 0. For all these, this is gonna be 4 now. This one's 0. This one's 0. And so, Jules, you got a name for your game or something? Oh, now it's a little too high. Maybe it should be more like -10. And we need a pathway. Maybe the top and the bottom. Oh, and it needs to be a little bit farther out. So say 4 to 6. And so if y is, let's do the bottom half. If y is less than center dot y and x equals w2, or we could get xd. We should probably get xd. So xd equals abs of center dot x minus x. So if xd is less than or equal to 1, then we're going to return from this method. So I'll add a pathway. Cool, you like the frogs? Nice. The squirrels? Yeah, critters. I love doing little things that have nothing to do with the gameplay. took the original sprites and edited them a bit. Yeah, Nintendo would definitely care if you're doing a commercial, if you're selling it. Probably even if you did it for free. I would think they would have a problem. But that's really not a question I can answer for you. That's really, it really gets into copyright law and stuff, and you really have to figure that out for yourself, man. And if you really are going to sell this thing, you better get a lawyer and figure that out, because that's really, really towing on the whole copyright infringement. Okay, so yeah, we got a path in here. This is looking better already. I'd like to see some fire or something as well. Yeah, even if it's free, it's kind of a tricky area. It's better that it's free. I don't know. I don't know how that works, man. I really don't. Okay, let's get a couple pieces of tiles for fire. Zelda Classic, of course, man. This is the one I'm making. This whole game you're looking at, Songbringer, is based on Zelda 1. Wait, are you talking about something else besides that? You mean The Legend of Zelda, the very first Zelda, right? Some torches? Yeah, totally. That's at least kind of what these are. Oh, there you go, which is so nice. Thanks, Wistiso. What's up, buddy? Here we go. There's a couple of them. Makes you look a little nicer. What else does this need? I'm thinking maybe this pillar in the middle could be taller. Right here. Like maybe extend a little farther up. That'd be kind of cool. Or maybe make the pool a little wider. Yeah. That'd be cool. Maybe I might add a path up here as well. Let's see what it looks like with the path. Oh, Zelda Classic is a game made for making your own Zelda 1 quests. Oh, I see. It's all called Zelda Classic. Oh, I hadn't heard of that. I've heard of the Zelda Randomizer. I haven't tried it out, but I've been meaning to try Zelda Randomizer for a while. But that's cool. That's cool. You can make it's like Mario Maker, basically, for Zelda. Oh, cool. Thanks, Viol. You mean add some more markings? It's got a few. I think the pool should be bigger for sure. I'll get to that here in a sec. Let's try having the path on the north and the south. Might add a little bit. Yeah, I could add more of them though, or make it taller and. Yeah, there are a lot of Zelda remakes. It's a great game. So yeah, I don't know if I like that. I think I'd rather have the water here, how it was, and then this pillar thing to be taller or something. Oh, small screen? Yeah. I hear you. Okay, so is there anything in general that this screen needs? I guess you could put some bushes around here. let's try some bushes and trees. Might be cool. So if the distance is greater than or equal, or greater than 6, let's do less than 6 there, greater than or equal to 6, and less than 7, we'll set some bushes for now. Or maybe some statues. Yeah. What about cliffs instead of water around the pool? Cliffs. That would be cool. A huge hole, yeah. That's interesting. How can I do that relatively quickly? What Kogo City X version am I using? Right now, 3.7. I haven't upgraded to 3.8 or 3.9 lately because I've been so busy. But yeah, 3.7. It's too many bushes. I agree. They would look like if they were all trees or all pillars or all statues. I really like the idea of having some. Yeah, I would have to create new tiles for that. I can't reuse that. That'd be a new thing. But I have been meaning to do that forever, adding depth, more depth to the world through cliffs and chasms and things like that, and bridges. I want to put bridges over those chasms. So it's kind of been on my list for a long time to do anyways. It actually would look really sick right here. How about, I think I want to finish this how it is right now. Like, I want to be able to use the cup, you know, to get into this dungeon. But I think I'll add that later. Like, this is already set up. It'd be so easy to make that a chasm tile or whatever later on. It's kind of crazy with all these trees. I wonder what it would look like with the fire closer to here. This one's 3. You like the well? Cool. I think I might make it a little bit bigger though. What about if these were statues? What would that look like? A giant LED sign saying, don't drink this. Whoa, that's weird. So statues should never be right next to each other. We'll see what they would look like though if they were staggered. This game definitely does not have enough LED signs. No. The trees were kind of cool. But what if they were a little bit random? So there's like a random chance to not have the tree. Why am I using floats? I use doubles for time, and I use floats for most of my position math. The reason I am using floats is because Coco City X uses floats. And so I kind of match what they're doing as far as their positions go. But I do use doubles for all time math, because time is really, really important. And doubles are, by default, way, way better. I agree. One of the bosses should be a dragon. I agree. There's gonna be some flying bosses that are gonna be pretty interesting. I think I liked it better without the random removing some of these trees. And I do want to see what it looks like with the fire close. So we'll go center.x minus maybe 2. Center.y plus 2. That's getting crazy. It made the water look weird. Toying with this idea of having the fire close. Yeah, the fountain statue is definitely too small. I think the fountain itself is too small. Now, make it the Easter egg of a slice of pizza with the caption, "Wish I had some Urn brew." What's Urn brew? I'm just trying to get the joke. Maybe let's try one more. Yeah, I am using the original res for tiles. No, it's close to the original. It's not exactly the same old school resolution like that, but it's pretty close. That's why the pixels are so big. See, of all the configurations so far, I kind of like this one. But it does make the water look really weird. But I guess if this turned into a chasm, it would be all right. One thing we do gotta do is guarantee that the next distance outward, so if the distance is greater than or equal to 7 and the distance is less than 8, then we need to make sure that is an empty tile so the player can definitely walk there. Iron brew. Oh, it's a fizzy drink. Oh, cool. Yeah. With the trees around it for entrance, could be a gate bush or how they're called. Oh, right. Oh, yeah, I could put some of those in there too. Okay, yeah, let's work on the artwork now. So I'll make this thing taller. Play with making the fountain maybe a little thicker. Yeah, this is okay for now. Alright. I plug in my graphics tablet. Let's do this. Looks spooky? Good. It's meant to look spooky. In this biome. Each biome kind of has its own feeling, you know? If this were something else, I guess it would be... probably wouldn't be as spooky. Especially with the squirrel. Right? Yeah, I have thought about weather, totally. I want to add rain, at least. Rain is easy, and it'll add a really cool element to the game. Oregon Trail? Yeah! Is that bagpipes I hear? Okay, so this thing could be taller, like at least 96. More crows. There's a crow on. The crow starts on every screen that you start on, but he does fly to different places. So there's only one crow in the game. He follows you, or I won't tell you what he's meant to do though. Was the bottom of the screen a different biome? Yeah, it was exactly. You're seeing Evermore. Let me show you what it looks like. A thunderstorm would be sweet. Yes, biome-specific enemies, creatures, yes. That's already possible. I can do that with the foes.txt. This thing's all set up for that. So if I put a certain foe, like for example, these sacks or whatever, I can go style dark forest or whatever, and it will only put that type of foe in that. So yeah, that's already set up. All I gotta do is add more specific enemies types and stuff like that for that. Nice. You got to put Easter eggs in your first game, man. So I will run around in God mode. You can see. So this is the dark biome, right? And then just below it in this area was the lighter forest biome. So yeah, so that's why there's these trees right here. They're coming from this area below it. So there's that kind of biome. There's this lighter forest biome. And then there's these are the mountains, mountain biome, and there's also sand. Let's see if we can find it. I don't know where sand is in this one. Oh well, but yeah, there's four biomes right now. Okay, so let's make this pillar taller. And I want to make this whole thing a little thicker too. All right, before I do too much, I'm just going to check the proportions. Let me see if that's about the right height before I draw this. Three entrance. This is the entrance object. Nice. Yeah, right on, Rega. What? Oh, it didn't. No. Oh, there. It just took forever to repack. Yeah, Scottish Pieces is going to be local multiplayer, and you'll be able to play as the main hero, of course, or the robot. So this little guy, a robot, his name is Jib. Right now he can distract enemies by... So if I go fight some enemies, you'll see what I mean. See, Jib's already, he's going off and trying to, like, annoy these enemies. So when enemies hit him, he takes damage, but he, if he loses all his hit points, he just recharges and then he's back alive. So he's invincible, but he's also cannot affect enemies. So he's an interesting character, and if, eventually he'll have more items and stuff like that to give him a few more abilities, but he'll always be a support character. He'll never be like a main hero. He's more of just like a supporting hero. All right. Yeah, let's wait. How tall was that? Yeah, that's a little better. And if the water was thicker, that would be pretty good. Yeah, okay. Cool. Let's combine these. Support character missions? Yeah. That's one of the ideas that was mentioned months and months ago, was to have a whole dungeon, a whole level where you play as Jib. And I think what'll happen is you get to some dungeon where you lose everything and you get thrown in jail. So Rock's in jail, but Jib is small enough that he can get out of jail. And so you play the whole level as Jib. I don't know how that'll work or whatever, but that would be really interesting, right? I think it'd be pretty fun to play as him, and it'd be cool to add that kind of variety to the game too. Yeah, totally. That's also one of the items that's planned, is to give Jib more abilities, but not to the point where he can damage foes, because it'll really upset the balance of the game if Jib can attack, unless the AI also automatically attacks as Jib. But I do agree, State Off, Axiom Verge did a great job with their drones, and it's really cool a concept that he had. Being able to shoot out your drone and then warp to it and all that. Oh, Paper Mario, yeah? I don't know if I played Paper Mario. Whoa, it's like the cartoon version. So Boogie, what was it like to play as Peach then? Did she have fully like all her abilities, or did she just have like, was she just a support character or what? Is it really? It's a good game series? Wow, cool. She was held captive, and then you get to sneak around the castle. Oh, cool. The boogeyman should be a boss? Yeah, boogie. Definitely. The boogeyman. But it's the boogeyman, not the boogeyman. Yeah, you know what? So, I don't know if I've told you guys this yet, but let me warp to the player to the to Songbringer, and I'll show you what I'm talking about. What's up, Trevor? Okay, so here's Songbringer, the ship, right? This is where there's the droid smith and your bike, and this is where you start the, well, you're not gonna start the game here anymore, but you do get back to here after level one. But on Songbringer is like Burning Man in space. There's like people dressed up weird. There's gonna be tons of people, like so many people on this ship. Tons of NPCs, people just chatting, people smoking weed, people drinking drinks. People just all around partying basically the whole time. There's gonna be the sound of music in the like thumping music that's in a different room, like it's kind of like attenuated, you know. There's the stage and all that. But basically, there's gonna be so many NPCs that I could add. I could add a boogeyman. Did I fix the bike? Not really, no. People dress up weird. See me in Earth. Yeah, the bike is, you can get on it and it looks okay, but once you're on it, it doesn't look that great when I take off. I'm really not happy with this art, but, oh, I broke it. What did I do? What did I do wrong? Bike mount. It should be the rock. Yeah, bike mount. What's wrong with this? A nim is null? Oh. I didn't even check that. Derpader. And what happened to his bike mount animation? Yeah, okay, so, right, you do crash your bike. So the game is gonna start with the Songbringer ship floating by, right? This is gonna be, you'll be able to come back to Songbringer after you crash the bike. So I'll explain kind of what happens. You see, at the very beginning of the game, you see the Songbringer ship floating by in hyperspace, like the beginning right now. And then you see Songbringer going into the planet, maybe like sort of Metroid style, you see the back of the Songbringer ship and it flies it down to the planet. The next thing you see is bikes or little dots basically coming out of Songbringer, and they turn out to be bikes. And there's like four different bikes that go flying off in different directions. Rock's one of these like scouts or whatever that's going to scout out the planet a little bit. And then the next thing, you wake up, you've crashed your bike. So basically you're one of the original scouts that's supposed to be scouting this planet. Everybody else is back on Songbringer partying, and you wake up, you're like, damn, I just crashed my bike again. And then eventually after the first level, you get your teleport cubes, and Jib's able to like retune it or whatever, so you can go back to Songbringer. You use the teleport cubes, go back to Songbringer, and that's when you get to meet everybody on Songbringer, and everybody's partying, and it's, yeah. So that's kind of how it's going to happen. And I was going to have the game start on Songbringer, but then when I saw people play it in person, it was confusing to see people like have to have all this, make all this choice at the beginning of Songbringer, and then have to make all the same choices again once they land on the planet. So I'm just going to make it simpler for players. So you'll still get back to the ship. It just takes a minute. Yeah. Yeah, totally. Yep, I could make NPCs like that, but let me be the one to surprise you all about that. A burglar holding a lighter? A pizza slice holding a Scottish flag? Yeah, what about Pedro? You can't deny that Pedro has been one of the best beta testers ever. Was he drunk or was he high? We don't know. He was something. Or maybe he was just not paying attention. Okay, this one's ready. Now let's work on making this a little bigger. Yeah, once you're right, totally. What's up, gutting? Call all my bugs Pedro's? Do you really want that? You're fine with that? Okay. All right, so how many pixels should this be bigger? I'm thinking 4 pixels extended. Oops. And 4 pixels, I think it would be 3 pixels high. Let's see what that comes out to be. 4 pixels times the ratio. That'd be 2.4. Looks like it'd be more like 2 pixels higher. Please no. Yeah, we all have to wait for Christmas. What's up with that? What's up, Kicks? Yeah, a few more pixels? Well, let me think about that. Oh, you know what? I messed up. You're right. You're totally right, Lighter Thief, because I added 4 pixels to the left, 4 pixels to the right. That should be 8 pixels total. Good point. Thanks, man. Always keeping my perspectives right. Thank you. So that should be 5 pixels. We need to add 3 more pixels. Hope song we produce would be under my tree. Cool. You might want to open it and try it out. Oh, right, yeah. What's up, Red Sands? Oh, what? So my girlfriend or my fiance and I got tickets to Star Wars tomorrow. Stoked. Super stoked. But don't anybody tell me what it's like. I want to be totally surprised and amazed or not, whatever happens tomorrow. Let it be. So that was 5 pixels, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Oh, this thing has a. I forgot about that. Yeah. So good. Nice. Everyone dies. No, that's Game of Thrones. Everybody knows everybody dies in Game of Thrones. It takes place in space. So, like, all y'all got to see Star Wars 2. This is like a global thing. I kind of like it like that. So there's the completed shebang. Let's hope that was about the right amount of addition to this old object. Oh. Yeah, you're gonna see it Sunday. Nice. Incursive Taylor. Oh yeah, dude, totally. The twist is that he could see dead people because he was dead the whole time. Nice one. All right, let's wait for this to repack textures and we should see what it looks like now. Whoops. Return of the Jar Jar. No. Ah. It's a horror. It's a horror flick. Return of the Jar Jar. It's good that it's bigger now. Okay, good. This is good enough. I want to now work on mechanics. So the next thing is to work on is getting this whole cup drinking animation thing to be aligned properly. Oops. Get the Z's going correctly. Yeah. Right. Okay, it also needs to be adjusted a little bit further down. Oops. World Three entrants. We got negative 10 right now. Let's do 16. This is going to become 12. That's 16. Jar Jar Abrams coincidence? The 70s Star Wars Christmas special? No, what's that? Yeah, there we go. That's looking good. Okay, next thing, let's get the overall. That thing needs to be four more on the left and the right, which is, here it is. Four more on the left to the right gives it 63. And then five more on the height. So that should be a bigger collision area. Yeah. Oh, I love it. That's a good. Was that made by what's his name? The famous poster drawer guy. He's a great oil painter and airbrush painter. What's his name? That guy that makes all the famous posters. Yeah, that's good. Got a nice walk around collision area. Everything's looking good. Okay, so mechanics. Let's get so when you use the cup, you can. Well, first of all, you can only use the cup near the fountain. It's crazy bad. The worst thing on television ever. Wow, I gotta check this out later on. See how bad it is. Alright, it's going in my homework pile. Okay, so let me think how this work is going to work mechanically. Elevator pitch. Chewbacca's family wait for him for Christmas dinner. Wow. I can't wait to check that out. Okay, so mechanics, how is this gonna work? Okay, I want it to only allow the player to use the cup if they're close right here or close on this side. This is totally possible. So I think it should have an exit component there. See that right there in the middle, there's already an exit component. But I think the exit component could be right almost the same width, but just allow one more pixel there on the edge. So you have to get really close and be matching that edge there, and then use your cup and you're good to go. A goblin teaches a boy to use magic to kill his father. That's good. Whoa. It needs a welcome mat. Give it a welcome mat. Yeah, it does need something right here. Yeah. Okay, after I do the mechanics. Alright, let's do. We want the entrance thing. It's going to be its own sub entity. So Yeah, I guess this could be called entrance, kind of. This is a collision category. Exit, yeah. We want it to be wider. Actually, let's put it below the fountain. So it's gonna be wider in the fountain. By like 65 to maybe 60, yeah, 65. That's only one pixel on each side, but yeah. And then not quite like 31, but more like 12 or something, pretty tiny. And then yeah, it's gonna have an exit component. I think it'll be called Flux Drink. This needs a position. Let's see if that's about the right size. How do I load the images? Yeah, they're all loaded on a single texture or a couple textures, and they're all loaded at the very beginning of the game. Yeah. Let me show Here's like what one of the textures looks like. Wait, let's see if I can just open it. Yeah, here we go. So there's one of the textures, right? It's got tons of sprites. Lots and lots of sprites and stuff. And this is all packed into one texture. And Coco Studio X. All right, Light of Thief, see you, man. Have a good one. Yeah, so then they're loaded into a single texture, right? And then they're split up into separate sprite frames programmatically at runtime by Coco Studio X. And it's pretty smart how it does it. There's also a plist file that accompanies this texture. So there's common.plist and common.pbr.ccz. And the plist just lists all the positions of all those little sprites. They're like sub sprites, basically. This is called a sprite sheet. All right, so did it work? Yeah, it was. That would be a funny NPC. Space chicken. How big is the texture so far? I think it was 2000 by 2000. This doesn't say. Yeah, it's 2048 by 2048. Yeah, there are limitations on Android, iOS. Yes, there are. I think 2000 by 2000 is about the max you want to go right now. If you're gonna, it depends on what devices you want to support. If you want to support the oldest devices, like if you want to support iPhone 3GS, you have to go all the way down to 1000. The max you can use is 1000. But everything above 3GS, like even the iPhone 4, iPhone 4S, those ones had a maximum texture size, I think, of 2048 by 2048. And then, like, your newer iPads and your newer ones all have, like, a max of, like, 4000 by 4000 or something. Arctic Skills, do I have any mobile games? Yes. Yeah, check out, it's called Hero Bash. It's my last video game I made. I made it with my buddy. We spent 2 years making it. It was a financial failure, though. But it's still a free game. You can play it. It's on iOS. Okay, so I need this one to be upwards. I want this like this little overlapping exit component thing here to be higher. So let's put it at not negative 12, but maybe more. Let's start at 0. Oh, thanks, Boogie. I still don't know the power of Bapu. Bapu is so great. Thanks again, Bapu. Yeah, about there. Maybe a little. Actually, yeah. If the player is right here. Oh yeah, the player can totally get that. Okay, and if the player is all the way at the top, barely touching this thing. Oh, that's a little too. It's too tall. So. Let's go down to maybe 8. Oh, it's 4S? Oh, thanks, Wusiso. Cool, I didn't know that. But there's some other reason why I went with 2048. I think there's some other platform where I'm kind of limited, and I don't know. You give people send in artwork for their own sprite? For the NPCs? Maybe. The thing about people submitting their own sprites is, like, I'm opening myself up to legal issues. If somebody submits their own sprite and then later on they're like, yo, you stole my art, you know, gosh, I don't know how I would do that. That's pretty good. So he's barely touching this sprite now. And yeah, that's about where we would want it. Okay, this is good. Okay, so now all I gotta do is make this behavior. So it makes it so it requires, for Rock to use the cup, he needs to be facing the fountain and he needs to be touching this exit component. No, I haven't seen the Twilight Princess remake. Really? Oh, Boogie. Boogie brings up a pretty good point, too. Style aesthetic is also a crazy thing, right? It's like, if I opened it up so people could submit their own art. Don't want to put people. The pool. So let's go. No. Let's get the actual exit component. So how do I get an exit component? There's gonna be a few different exit. Is there already an exit system way to get enable exits, lock exits? I want to find an exit. Let's make a find exit function. Exit system find, and this is going to be based on flux type. So flux type, let's get this compiling. All right, now exit system.cpp. Man, I feel great writing a small function before when I know I need to, you know what I mean? I'm actually pretty proactive here by doing that. Usually what I'll do is I'll write a function and then, or I mean, I'll write some code and then later be like, oh, I should make this a function. But this time I actually made it a function first. Yay for me. I feel like a proper programmer. I feel like a proper pragmatic programmer person. Whoa, sorry. Oh, dang. So your guys's chat just came in all of a sudden on me, like a bunch of chat messages, and looks like I was off. Was I off? Oh no. It might be working now. I was sitting over here telling jokes and stuff. The stream was off there for like 30 seconds or so. Yeah, I think it was just the stream died there for a second. I'm not sure what was up. It's back? Okay. The DEA caught him. Wait, what did that just say there? Did that actually say... Oh, it has a shitload of drop frames. But it's not dropping any right now. It might be because my fiance is watching Game of Thrones or something. Yeah, try refreshing too. Okay, so I'm making a little function to find an exit component based on flux type. So if... Oh, we got to get this exit component. If exit.flux. Working now, sweet. Whoa, what's up? What's up, guys? I'm back. So I was telling jokes and I was saying some of the most profound stuff ever. Not really, but I kind of was. All right, so exit flux type equals type, then return. Ian. There, we've now written a function to find an exit component based on its flux type. We can go back to here, and we're going to get the exit. So auto ref exit equals exit system find. Hey, what's up, J2? Yeah, I was giving away Steam keys, stickers. Oh, by the way, I have all these stickers I need to start giving away. Yeah, dude, I need to make some kind of like that. I need to get that thing working with the, whoa, what's this? Yeah, I got stickers. All I'm saying is I got stickers and I want to give them away so I can mail people these stickers like for something. Like, we'll have some kind of contests or weekly contests or daily contests on the stream. I don't know. Maybe weekly. It'd be hard to mail something every day. I want to walk all the way to the post office every day. But yeah, I got a lot of stickers to give away. So this should be fun. Did the stream die again? I think it might have died. What's up, stream? Oh, you're okay. You're okay, pretty stream. You're okay, pretty stream. That's right. Oh, you're still there. All right, cool. Yeah, so something. Make some kind of contest for that. Find. We want K flux drink. We gotta do a drink flux type. Constants. Flux. We got K flux drink. Compile. Now in constants.cpp, we can hook up the word for drink to the exit component. So when I create an exit component from data, we can create one that's the kflux drink. There. And in data, oh, category exit. No, let's do category none. Yeah, no category for that. I think that's going to work. What did it, why did it do this? Too few. Oh, find cave flux drink. Yeah, sticker command for points, sure. Yeah, the game Hero Bash? Yeah. Sorry, man. That's an old game. Wrote it back in 2013. We released that. And that was a game I made with my buddy. And it's not been updated since then. So there's a lot I could do to make that game awesome, but I'm not going to touch it at this point. I got a great project I'm working on here called Songbringer. It's taking up all time. All the time in the universe is being taken up. Taken up? I'm sorry you're confused by the game, but yeah, if you're confused, just don't play it, man. Tartar, don't tell us. Don't tell us, only like one of us has seen it. Don't tell us anything about it though, please. What's up with this? Why isn't this working? Oh, this needs to be system int or exit gig component. Entity get exit component for exit system find. Now, if we don't even have this exit component, this whole thing should not even, well, actually, that's okay. Oh, we actually need the entity. So, yeah, we'll go system int e, got that, and we go e.id there. Now we can go, if the player's position is greater than the exit's, wait, what did I do? Oh yeah, that's cool. Is greater than, oh no, not e, f, this is getting confusing. Yeah, yeah, he is. Yeah, Scottish Pizza. My friend that I made that game with, he's working on a book. So he's a great writer. He's working on this this amazing sci-fi fantasy. No, I think it's just fantasy. I'm not sure, but he's working on some book ideas right now. Bye, Arctic Seaman. Okay, so okay, we'll call this one exit, and this one exit component. Okay, so if exit.position.pause.x there. If exit.id, ooh, that was wrong. If exit.id is zero, then we should totally bail on this whole method. Okay, next things we need to check. We need to make sure the player is in the right flip X position. So if they're, if the hero's position.x is greater than the exit's position, then you should be flipped. Yes, that's correct. Okay, so if the player's render.sprite.isFlippedX is FlippedX. I'm pretty sure that's the method. Yeah, there we go. Slow autocomplete. What am I gonna do for the end of the game? Ha! I'm not telling. I got the whole plot outlined. It's gonna be dope. I will give you a hint. It has something to do with this. This thing over here. This tower thing. Yeah, it's gonna be interesting. I promise it'll be really interesting. It'll be a cool ending to the game. I don't want to give it away though. What's up, Valesan? Doing good, man. How about yourself? Good night of sleep. So if your flipped x is not equal to should be flipped x, then we gotta. Yeah. Next thing. Right? Ship. It is. Well, I shouldn't say anything else. I shouldn't say anything else. Try not to say anything else. It's hot there. I read something about how our water in the West, the Pacific Ocean, when we get the El Nino over here, which we have this year in El Nino, you guys have super drought. And when we have our super drought, you guys have super wet. What the heck is that?
I'm not saying your name on it.
I bet you it's all your presents. It's hot in here though. Wow. Dang, that's like the biggest box I've ever gotten from Amazon. Whoa. Yeah, you could still get the alpha on Steam. Tower grows out of the ship. That's not what I was thinking, but that's kind of cool. The sound's out of sync? You mean my voice? La 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 la. Hello. It looks like it's okay here. Are you talking about this sound out of sync? Right. Merry Christmas. Here's your box. Okay, let's see if we've got this working so far. Do you think you should use? Yes, I do think you should use comments to make things more readable. So, Jules, always make your code as readable as possible. Dang, 100. Whoa. That should always be a goal of yours, 'cause you might have a good memory about your project right now. Everything's all in your head. Things are great, right? You understand exactly how your code works. But I swear, you come back in 6 months, see if you're still that familiar with it. You're not gonna be that familiar with it unless you're a genius, which remembers everything. But usually you need to make things as readable as possible so it's very easy for you to remember how something worked very quickly. Okay, so if I face this direction and use the cup, oh, it allowed me to do it, damn it. Okay, if I face this direction, it doesn't matter. What? What? Set a breakpoint there. Sound's not in sync with the stream. Oh, this sucks. Sorry, guys. I don't know. I think it's maybe because I restarted. It looks like it's okay on this end, so maybe the recording will be okay on YouTube, but maybe the Twitch stream is off. I'm hoping. Sorry about that, guys. Usually the sound is in sync for this stream. It's pausing and lagging. Damn. Sorry about the stream quality today, guys. I don't know what's up. I come back and think 6 months, things is right on. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah, J2's got some good comments here too. Don't put too much comments. Write your code so it's self-explaining. Totally. Totally agree. Proper naming of variables, yeah. Comment everything? Well, see, that's up to you. Is it readable? If you comment everything, just make it readable. That's all. Yo, Zyngar, what's up? Oh man. Stream issues. Okay, I'm debugging some code here. I'm figuring out why this didn't work. Let's check that E should be the player. Yeah, this is entity ID 1, rock, cool. This is the exit component. This thing. Should have a position in the middle of the screen. Yep. Cool. Should have a collision component. With no category, but it does have a size. Yeah. Okay, yeah, that's the right component. And then this exit component thing should have, yeah, K-Flux drink. All right, that's all good. Not to comment what the code does, because that should be obvious from reading it. But rather, why the code is doing that thing. Yeah, Bills, and that's a good thing right there, because that's really what you want to get, is when you come back to your code or whatever, or someone else is looking at your code, it's the first thing you want to know is why. The second thing you want to know is what. Why and how are kind of both up there. All right. Should be flip decks. True. Yeah. An exit ID. Exit ID is fine. It's been working out sweet. Yay. Is it delayed? Is the audio delayed? Oh, what do the stickers look like? Let me show you. They look exactly like the picture I always show, the background. Just because it's become so iconic. But they look like this. They're like 4 inches by 3 inches or so. They're little stickers. You can, you know, peel them off, stick them wherever you want. But yeah, I'm going to be giving these away somehow. Do some kind of contest for points or whatever. Like if you guys do the command points, you can see how many points you have. You get points for watching. That's the command you want to enter. It'll show you. Got any tips for brainstorming ideas? Yeah, I kind of do. I think you should get inspired. Get yourself in a state of being inspired, right? So whether that's whatever it takes for you to get in an inspired state. Like maybe you get inspired when you watch movies. Maybe you get inspired when you take a shower. Maybe you get inspired when you listen to great music. You know, get yourself in that kind of state of mind where you're feeling inspired. And then for brainstorming, don't ever reject ideas. You want to allow every possible idea. And there's also the mind mapping technique. You can mind map. Have you heard of mind mapping? Mind mapping is where you start with one idea, you circle it, and then you just draw it to another idea where you circle that and circle that and circle that. Here's a funny one. This is kind of what it's like, right? This is a mind map. You can use mind maps for brainstorming too. Or you could just, you know, smoke weed and get high. There's plenty of ways to get inspired for a game idea. Personally, I like to go for hikes. I like to go, whenever I'm walking, I'm really inspired. Yeah, J2, good point. The 110-1 method for game design. Oh, I gotta check this out. This looks like a sweet article. Cool. More homework. What's this other one? Funny code comments. Throw up, haha. When I wrote this, only God and I understood what I was doing. Now God only knows. Drunk, fix later. Magic, do not touch. This is great. Yeah, Pedro, you got 210 points. So wait, okay, so we got points working. Thank you, Bafu. Thank you, Boogie. How many points should you get to have to be for you to get a sticker? How much is 1 point again? What are my favorite artists for music? Lately, I love Rush. I've been really loving Rush. But you know, growing up, I love Tool. Tool is one of my favorite bands. Gotta love Tool. I love Maynard's voice. I love everybody in Tool. This is such a great band. But I love Rush these days. Rush is so good. Rush is awesome. They're so influential. They're amazing. I love Led Zeppelin, of course. I love that kind of rock. Like Led Zeppelin. I love classic rock. You know. One point every 5 minutes. All right. One of five from Steam Key. What you mean there? So, wait. So, if it's 5 minutes and you're watching for, I don't know, one stream would be how long? So, if it's 5 minutes, then one stream is 120 minutes. You get 24 points for watching a stream. So, what? Maybe you watch three streams or five streams? Five streams, maybe. Or four, I guess. Four would be 100. Maybe like an even 100 points should be you get a sticker. I don't know. Start writing all your IDs, even the most random ones. Yeah. Piece of lore, specific panic. Oh, so when you have 100 of them, you pick the 10 most promising one, build a quick prototype for all those. Then test the prototypes with people. Oh, that's cool. That's a cool idea. I like that. The 110 one. Def Leppard? Yeah, I've heard Def Leppard. I should check him out again, though. Oh, the points? So, yeah. See, Valesen, you just type, exclamation points, just like Reggae Knight did. Right, yeah, combined. Okay, so yeah, I'll think about that. And if you guys have suggestions on that, let me know what you think. Man, dude, that's so cool. Boogie, dude, you're awesome. Oh, you have to be following too. Boogie, dude, you're so awesome. Thank you again for doing that. It's so cool. So cool. Yeah. Oh, I know. I wish there was a way you could get credit for watching the YouTube videos too, but yeah. Yeah, you know what? I'll probably honor that anyways. If somebody really wants a sticker and they're like, dude, I've watched every one of your live streams or your YouTubes, I'll just give him a sticker anyways. I'm not going to be stickler about that. What to do with them? Oh, Valesen. Yeah, so what do you do with it? Well, that's what we're trying to talk about right now is, you know, using your points for either getting a sticker or for getting a copy of the game. Copy of the game would be more points than 100. I'm sure certain, because that's right now it's a $64 value to keep the honor of the Kickstarter alive. To say thank you once again to all you Kickstarter backers that made this project possible. This project would not be possible without the support of you. Yeah, it's okay, Jules. I'll still send you a sticker. It might cost me like $5 or whatever to send you a sticker, but it's cool. Oh, should it be an automatic win or a raffle or a dice roll? Ooh, I don't know. What do you guys think? Yeah. Oh, Rega, yeah, you can upgrade your pledge too. Totally. I should say that 1,000 times. I mean, if anybody is out there and you want to upgrade, if you pledge to the Kickstarter and you want to upgrade, or you already pre-ordered the game and you want to upgrade your pre-order, totally just get in touch with me. Email me at nat@wizardfoo.com. nat@wizardfoo.com. That's my email. And let me write it here in the chat too. And so just communicate with me. I'll totally figure it out. Whatever you want to do. You can like PayPal me the difference or whatever. And yeah. You want to jib blush? How many points? I know if it is auto win. Yeah. I do want to, like, I don't know. I could give away 5 stickers a week or something. That wouldn't be too much. I could go to the post office just once a week and send them all off. 5 or 10, I don't know. Okay, so I've been sitting here trying to debug this for a while. I'm wondering why it didn't... See, it skipped that because... Oh, this is or. Should be or. Duh. Yeah. What do you mean? Why aren't you contributing? Huh? Oh, what does the $4 one include? It gets you the game right now, so you get to play the alpha version, and it's permanent, so you get to play every version of the game from now on. You get the alpha versions, the beta versions. You also get your name in gold on the main menu, so let me show you what that's like. When you're on the main menu, there's people's backer names. Let's see if one shows up as gold. There's like, you know, a small percentage of people who have gotten the gold backer status or whatever. But yeah, so this is, you get your name in gold. I don't know if it'll show at one, but... You also get, for leaderboards, you're going to get a special icon next to your name. So eventually the game will have leaderboards. There's one. Nathan Ferguson. Thanks, Nathan. Yeah, so on the leaderboard, when there eventually are leaderboards, your name will have a special icon. Okay. Let's see if that worked now. Okay, so if I'm facing this direction here, I should not be able to use the cup. Alright, cool. And if I'm facing this direction, I can use the cup. Yay! Let's turn the entrance part. I think this is the order flag, so there. So that should look right when you dip the cup in. Oh, Jules, what's with the black bars? It's because the game is currently designed for a specific ratio. So the black bars are because it's filling in some black content. But I am gonna add more content, so the game will be able to have a flexible ratio. So, for example, like on the bottom of this screen, there would be a little bit more content from the area below it. And the top of this screen would have a little more content from the area above it. And therefore, on bigger screens or differently sized screens, you wouldn't have to have those black bars. So, I know that can be annoying to see those, right? There we go. Now he looks right. But the only problem now is that you can stand on top of this. So I need to figure out I gotta do like a separate component to this whole fountain for the back and make the back a separate thing. Yeah, I can figure that out somehow. Okay, so next thing is going to make it so he can only use the cup if he's touching that exit component. So if he was right here, he would not be able to use it. Yes, Scottish pizza, it does. Yeah, so all the higher pre-order things, the $64 one includes the $32 one as well as the $16 one. The $32 one includes the $16 one as well. And all that info is on the pre-order page. If anybody's like wondering what we're talking about, it's on songbringer.com/pre-order. And it goes into detail about what each one has. If you just scroll down a little bit, it tells you about what each one of those is. Pizza two nights in a row. Oh, thanks, Pedro. You want a PDF map of Poopy? I can't wait to do the PDF maps. Those are going to be fun. So basically what I'll do is I'll make it so the world generator thing, this thing will show you actual screen. So it'll generate this whole screen, take a screenshot of it, and repeat that process for every one of these levels. And then this whole thing will be an actual picture of the world. Stop eating my people. Okay, so how to make it so you're touching, that would be the exit component. Actually, I don't even know if we need this or this. So the exit component, how do I do checks in the collision system? Poopy and no beer. Don't judge me. Oh, here. His intersection. My paws, my size. Your paws, your size. Yeah, that's what I need to call. Okay, so if it's a collision, or if it's not a collision, if not collision system is intersection of the player's position, e dot position dot pause, player size, e dot collision size, exits point, exit dot position dot pause, exit dot collision dot size. So there, if we're not colliding, then we're not going to be able to use this. Mountain Dew, pizza, and Songbringer. Dude, that's great. You like Mountain Dew? When I was in college, I loved Mountain Dew so much that I made a wall. I actually had an entire wall of empty Mountain Dew cans. It was like my programming juice. I was like addicted to Mountain Dew. It was pretty bad. My friends had to have an intervention. So, okay, right here, I shouldn't be able to use it. Only here. Okay, that'll work. That'll work. Wait, did that work? Oh, yeah. It still worked. Cool. make sure this side works. You guys don't have cans? Except for last week. Really? Pedro, that's weird. It used to work. Oh my god, really? So when did that happen? I used to type Songbringer, and it was the first result. Oh, now it's the kickstart. No, it's the second result for me. Wait, what if I go to... Maybe that's because I'm logged in. Wait, what browser, what search engine are you using? Oh yeah, it's the second result. Pedro, man, search engine? Yeah. Whoa, Australia never had caffeine? Whoa. Pedro, are you logged in though? Are you logged into Google? Because when you're logged in, it gives you different results. Yeah, these are all great results. I'd be happy to have someone check out the Kickstarter or my site or not this one. This should be redirected to that. Press sheet. Yeah, these are all great. Okay, let's check the other sides here. Wow, so yours has songbringer.com first. Wow. So interesting. We all got different results. Oh, yeah. That's cool, man. So you do it in honor of him or just so you don't get it as well? Or you don't get, you know, develop diabetes. All right, we're good there. If I turn around. I love this. It's such a secret, right? You have to know to use your cup right there. Which it makes sense. I mean, you have to, I guess. Wait, can you go one more pixel back? Actually, yeah, it needs to be one. Have one more pixel. Right here, the water. Needs a pixel right here. Ah. Yeah. Oh, that's weird. So you are logged in then, I'm imagining. Well, cool. That's good to know. Oh, okay. So if you're not logged in, oh, I see. I wonder why it changed it for you. It's weird. All right, good night, Jules. See you, man. Squirrel. He has, man. He's been kicking it. He's kicking it on that screen for hours and hours. Wait, what happened here? Oh. There. Okay, I'm going to re-export this water. You know what? Before this stream is done, I gotta at least get to see you wake up inside the dungeon. Yeah. Oh, I know, right? No Snickers? Man. Oh. Let's see what it would look like if you got one more pixel on each side. So this was 67. You'd be able to stand a little farther away from it, so it might make it a little less hard to use. I don't want it to be too difficult for people. There's nothing fun about little tiny ones. What's Squirrel doing? I don't know. What is he doing? That looks okay. Yeah, that's good. Oh, that was okay. Good. Okay, yeah, now we got a 2-pixel buffer there. Okay, next up is to make it so when he actually drinks and falls, and he falls over, the screen fades out, and he wakes up in the other dungeon. And then the mechanics are basically done. Yes! Love saying that. The mechanics are done. Mojito. Whoa. No, Boogie, the AI does not move around on adjacent screens, right? It's just everything is contained on a certain area. And in fact, if I were to zoom out the camera, there would be nothing around it. So there's really nothing for them to wander to until you actually trigger the flux into the new area and it creates a new one. Okay, so the next thing we need to do is create a flux for this. Liquid drops? Oh, that's a good idea. So the new area pause is going to be the current area's exit dest. Transient id flux type. Okay, so now this code is going to belong in the flux, this new flux we're making, flux CPP. I'll put it at the end of everything for now. Flux capacitor, yes.
Have a good time, you look gorgeous.
I do. Mm-hmm. Sure.
Yes.
Okay. Bye, baby.
Bye.
Okay, now I gotta hook up this new phase. There we go. Here's where we hook it up into the different phases to run. Right? Oh, whoa. That's good. Okay, we got a phase going. An unboxing for the presents. Robert Plant? Oh, man. This is going to be... Oh, yeah. Let's do Robert Plant. Yeah, he should definitely be a character on there. Yes. Definitely his old 70s look. His new look's cool, too. I like him as old Robert Plant. But, like, the young Robert Plants would be the one I would want to put in the game. Good idea. Ah, no. No, she doesn't. Bacon is sugar-free. Yeah! Dude, you could definitely take solace in that. Okay, so this thing needs a transition duration. That's pretty important. We'll do 4 seconds and then fade out. I don't even need a tick. Yeah, it would actually, Boogie, good point. So after we do this whole phase, we fade out. That should be it. We should be able to fade out, and then it'll automatically do a fade in the new area. Grams of processed meat a day. Yeah. Thanks for posting that, Dodge Whale. But you can get bacon. You can get bacon without it being processed.
No, all bacon is processed.
What? All bacon is processed?
It's the processed meat. Yeah.
I thought you could get slices of pure bacon.
You could get slices. It's all processed. It's just either cured or uncured.
You can't get uncured, unprocessed bacon?
I think it's a processed meat, but I could be wrong. Well, actually, no. No, you're right.
The dudes at Burning Man always jigged these huge slices of awesome local bacon.
Replicate that.
This is a debate for later. Maynard James Keenan? Yeah. He's definitely one of my favorite singers of all time. I probably will put him in the game just to be like, just because I have to. All right, let's see if that worked. So the player would potentially wake up inside this dungeon. Okay, so I'm gonna go bip. Didn't work. I got lost my controls. It looks like it is fluxing. Something really bad happened. I don't know what happened. Wait. Oh. There's one other thing. That when it starts a flux, it needs flux drink, starts with the phase, cave phase, drink. Yeah, you got to see him live recently? Cool. How was it? I've never seen Pucifer live myself. I'll stick with that. Oh, it could be prosciutto and bacon. Two definitely different things. Yes, we're drinking. We're falling over. We woke up in the weird dungeon. All right. Yes. It was a little too quick, though. Let's work on the timing of stuff. 11:10. Oh, good. It kept with position. All right. So phase drink. It needs to be a little longer, so like, you know, 6 seconds or something before it fades out. It was weird how... Oh my gosh, I think the lying down animation... Wait, no. I'm wondering why it flipped him over. Let's see that again. Red Hot Chili Peppers? Sure. Totally. You feel smarter being here? Okay. Okay, I don't want him to do that last animation until the app, until it starts the next. So maybe it needs to go. Oh, I know. If it's fading in, so where is this? Fade in. Phase, fade in. And the current flux type is K-flux drink. We'll make the player do this lying down animation before it fades in. That should work. Oh, thanks, Pedro. Yeah, I know, I'm getting hungry already. That's like my sign is like, okay, am I hungry? Probably need to stop the stream soon. Yeah. People got stuff to do. I got you. All right, I hear you. Okay, guys. Well, this is about it. So, just to recap what was done today. I've been working on this scene here. This is the entrance to a dungeon. This is a secret/optional dungeon where you have to know what's up to be able to get here. Like you find this cup on Songbringer. This is your red cup, your red solo cup. And then you use it to drink from this fountain. You drink this poisons or acid or something. You're drinking something and you wake up inside this dungeon and you're totally tripping. And then it's just a different style dungeon. And in this dungeon, there's gonna be no Jib. You don't have Jib to help you. And also your sword's missing. And this is just weird. I don't know, this is totally like a bug, a glitch going on with these clouds or whatever is here, but. That's the point. That's how this is all going to work. So I'm really happy that all the behavior is done and the graphics are done for this scene. So later on today, I'll be working on finishing this up and getting it so this next area looks good. But yeah. Yeah, nice, J2. See you, man. Later, everybody. Have a good night. Catch you next time. Tomorrow, probably. Wait, no. Tomorrow I'm seeing Star Wars, so maybe late tomorrow. We'll see.